All right, guys, so today we're out here. We're at Lacey, Blair, and Zach's home base. We're actually powder coating my lift, so I'm pretty excited. They're inside right now, getting ready to shoot our powder. So we're gonna go in there, we're gonna check it out. All right, so now we see the color. This is green. Picked it just because I feel it's so close to my original lime green color. There is an accent color that's gonna come into play here and really kind of be able to break up this lime green. It's very bright. I personally haven't seen this lime green on trucks. There's only so many colors to pick from, but I did this just because I feel like it's so unique and it matches kind of my company. So I think it's badass. Check it out. See, they actually just laid the clear coat onto this green. See, me as someone that doesn't do powder coat and doesn't really know much, I would never know that clear is actually white, so kind of cool. That clear coat is what's gonna give it that real pop and kind of help this powder act a little better in UV. This powder color is actually not UV rated at all and it will fade in the sun. Even with this clear coat, it's still gonna fade, and Lacey's made us well aware that it will. This truck's really gonna live inside most of its life, other than it's weak at SEMA, so I'm not really particularly too worried about it. And there's kind of a plan with this truck after this that I haven't really talked about, and I'm not going to. So most of this stuff is really just for the SEMA show, and then after SEMA, we have more in store for you. But anyways, this is what our clear looks like when it gets laid on there, once it comes out of the oven, nice and clear, and it gives that green a perfect pop, helps protect it a little bit too. So check it out. Out of the oven, I think it is absolutely glass. It's exactly what I expected. Very, very lime green, that pop, that heavy glittery flake that just, I haven't seen. Sure, it's out there, but I haven't seen it. So to me, I think it's gorgeous. It's everything I could have wanted, you know. These rotors, Lacey, this is how she does it. After this, she's actually gonna turn these rotors, get all the powder coat off of them, back down to bare, fresh. Those are brand new. I'm putting a lot of money in this truck, man. I even bought new rotors. I didn't want to, but I did.
Food haul, Chick-fil-A, you know what it is. We got the sauce. Hopefully we got the sauce. You know, I think that's okay because we should have backup in the fridge. But I just got a salad. We're about to find out. Yes! Wait. Barbecue. Oh, they didn't give us any sauce.
So we ended up finishing up over at Lacey Blair's for today. Tomorrow we got some axles still left to powder coat, some leaf springs. We're waiting on BCC Zach to actually press out our final bushings out of our leaf springs. I've had a hell of a time getting those suckers out. So anyways, Zach's gonna do that for us using hydraulic press. On top of that, now I have to get my JTX Forge wheels polished. Yesterday we ended up training Lacey Blair on this barrel, and we made a great how-to video that'll be on her YouTube channel. We'll check in, see the full polishing process from sanded to cut to colored to finish, with Lacey Blair doing all the action and me just trying to teach her how to do it. It's really not easy. If you guys want a good laugh, that's probably where you want to go, because it is kind of funny. Anyways, we're gonna get with it, cut these things out. I'm gonna re-sand this barrel because there were a couple little imperfections that we didn't quite get right, and I want to get those things freaking
Cherry Kiss, right.
Also, I wanted to shout out PPE. They reached out to me. They sent me these diff covers. I'm also wearing their shirt. That just happened by accident. I don't really know how that worked, but I'm super stoked, especially on these diff covers. I've always wanted diff covers like this. Never really coughed up the change to buy them. And I'm going to be honest, getting them powder coated is 100% worth it. They just look fuego as can be. I've never looked at a diff cover and honestly been happier. So I would tell you, if you're ever thinking about it, it's definitely worth it. All right, guys. So our days here in Texas are winding down. This whole shop is green. Miss Lacey has set us up with probably some of the best powder I've seen. We did a durability test, smashed the hell out of a green rim. No chips for the people that are gonna be like, oh, it's gonna chip. Nope, but over here we have my leaf springs. These things are sick. I've actually always in my life always wanted springs powdered. Now it kind of sucks that my F250 only has three leaves, and I was gonna get F350 leaves, but I'm gonna be honest, we're balling on a budget, so I'm not. Everything here has turned out incredible. Right here we have my axles. These just got out of the oven too, so they're extremely hot. I'm really, really, really happy with them. I mean, the powder couldn't be any more perfect. These guys really know what they're doing too. Like everything with them, like I didn't know how to pop out the bushings or all the little stuff, and these guys are incredible. They taught me how to put them back in. They took them out. They're awesome. Like I couldn't ask to have done work with better people. These guys put a lot of pride into their work and it's incredible. Over here, we have our entire Poppy's Garage 6 to 8 inch lift kit. Didn't go that big with a lift because simply I want my engine bay to be seen. And I feel like at SEMA, that's the big thing is these massive, big, tall trucks. And it's really cool. But as I said earlier, I'm balling on a budget. And really, I do want my engine bay to be seen. So here we have my Poppy's Garage kit. It's an 8 inch lift. That's where we're going with it, a 6 to 8 kit, but I went 8. I wanted to get that little bit of size so I could probably clear a 38 inch tire, and I'm really happy with it. So one of the most controversial things, and I see a lot of people are upset about, is my rotors. And what you guys don't realize is Lacey does this for a reason. It just adds a little extra braking power as my pads will grind on the powder coat, and I think it's gonna add a lot of stopping power to my truck. Just kidding. Lacey's been doing this a while. She knows exactly what she's doing. If you followed her or know her journey at all, she's been powder coating for a lot of years. Same with Zach. They follow quality over quantity, as their poster reads. Reason being that we did that is they can bring them now down to a shop and they're actually gonna turn the rotor and get us down to fresh metal. It just works better that way. It's a cleaner look. I think it's the way to go, and I think it's gonna look really good for a show truck. After SEMA, we're gonna have some good stuff coming. Right here, we have my coil springs. These are going on a carbon kit. And then right here, we have my U-joints. Those came out incredible. The carbon kit, we're doing a full coilover conversion on the front end. So I'm pretty excited to do that. That's gonna make this truck ride a ton better. As everyone knows, straight axle trucks just ride like dog dookie. So I can't go IFS, but we're gonna go with some coilovers to make it ride really nice, nice carbon kit. So pretty excited with that. Carly suspension is supposed to be the top notch from what I've been told. I wouldn't know them, so we're gonna give it a shot. PPE had also hooked us up with these differential covers. These things are absolutely incredible. We showed them in the sun, and I mean, even inside, the flake is just mesmerizing. I didn't really know what I wanted for a secondary color, and Lacey had recommended we did this gray. This gray has a ton of metallic in it. I'm gonna be honest, they know their stuff. It just looks incredible. Really, the only thing we have left to do is two more of my JTX4's wheels. My JTXs are beautiful. They're actually over here. I didn't really do a finish polish on these. I got them to the point now where I can polish these out without affecting their powder coat. They came out really nice. The reason I don't do a finish polish on these is there's always that chance of scratches from them wiping the powder, the overspray. So I'd rather not put the stress on them to not micro scratch it or really any of that. So I just got them where they need to be so that now I can run a really nice cut through there and get those wheels exactly where I'm gonna want them. Again, we went with the secondary color, which is actually the gray on the wheels versus the green. Green lays really rough. It's tough to get that stuff to lay flat because it's so chunky. Coming out of the gun, it wants to kind of bind up and it creates these bumps. Lacey did an incredible job at getting everything to lay as flat as it possibly can. Axles always seem to be really rough out of powder. I've seen a lot of powdered axles. And even with this color being such a war, she did an incredible job. If you look at all of my housing and everything, it is really flat for what a chunky powder it is. The reason it's chunky is the size of the flake, and she tried steering me away from it, but me being the stubborn kid I am, I kept up with it. And honestly, I think she absolutely knocked it out of the park. It's really all we got left in Texas right now. It's two of my wheels. I'm gonna polish some parts for Zach, and back to Connecticut we go. As for our secondary color here, you can see this gray. This gray is a beautiful, beautiful gray. I'm a very big fan of it. This is actually gonna match my frame color very well. I went with an actual Ford color for my frame, just to kind of keep it, I guess, OEM to me. I like that color because it's so dark on my frame. It's not gonna stand out and be like, look at me as a frame, because I feel like my axles and my lift components are gonna take so much attention. I didn't want my frame to absolutely scream and say, look at me, because that's what my lift and axles already does. So I think it's gonna blend together very nicely. All right, so we're boiling down. It's our last day in Texas. Finally have everything done. The last two wheels from JTX are done over here. They came out absolutely incredible. I still gotta do my finish polish on these, so they're gonna be a bit brighter, but I just got these to a good state from where they were, so that now I can get a really nice polish on these without ruining the powder coat. It's kind of like a big thing that I try to do before powder. I don't want to be sanding with 180 grit on a back face. When I got these, they were in kind of a sanded state, which was totally fine. Super, super, super stoked to work with that company. On top of that too, we finally have all of our knuckles out for our U-joints. Those are all powdered now back into our gray. We ended up switching the color onto those. Those were going to be green, but I kind of wanted to go with this two-tone look, so really stoked on that. But super thrilled that Lacey could get this powder coat done on my truck and that she was willing to work with me on this. So it's awesome, man. Anyways, huge thank you to Zach and Lacey for having us down here and doing some work for us, letting me do some work for them. Let's check it out one more time.
See you guys at SEMA.